is this laptop for you? Well, I'll definitely answer that in a short while, but first let me tell you that today we are going to unbox and take a close look on the Lenovo IdeaPad 320. And this laptop packs in some decent specs and a very well balanced hardware for your day-to-day computing requirements. I'll also share some of my personal opinions regarding this laptop, so stay hooked to this video till the end and you will end up liking this video for sure. But first of all, hit that red subscribe button down below and that bell icon too, so that you get notified every time a new video goes live on our channel. Now, answer to your question. So my answer would be yes. If you use this laptop for web browsing, casual usage like watching movies, playing light games, or you are an early college going student, and the important category, programmers, like people who just started programming. In our terms, we call them noobs. So you can go for this laptop because programming doesn't need heavy resources. So having a i3 CPU with a 4GB of RAM is more than enough for your programming needs. Trust me, going for i5 or i7 for your programming needs is not necessary until and unless you're not using some heavy IDEs like Android Studio. So if you're using it for web development or like starting with C, C++, Java and all, so this laptop is best suited for you. So you got your answer. So if you think this laptop is for you, so stay hooked to this video till the end. And if you think it is not for you, then you can stop this video here. So let's begin. This is the box of the laptop. I already opened up the box during delivery to check the box contents and suggest you also to do so. Opening up the box, first of all, there's a charger and here it is. And its output rating is 20 volts at 2.25 amperes, which means it's a regular 45 watt charger with this kind of pin. Going ahead, there's some documentation which I don't know who reads. And finally, here's our laptop. It's so compact and thin, I would say. Also, the Onyx black color and the texture looks nice. Here you can see it's looking cool. Although it's quite slim and has a sturdy body, still it weighs easily around 2 kg to 2.5 kgs. By the way, the body is made up of plastic, but the build quality is quite impressive, I would say. And if I open up the lid of the laptop, you can see that the lid can be opened up to 180 degrees, like any other IdeaPad laptop. Although I can't get the point why Lenovo adds this, as the display isn't an IPS panel, so you cannot see anything on the display when it's rotated. But yeah, here it is. Well, let's proceed ahead and take a physical overview of the laptop. On the left side, it has a charging port, then a RJ45 Ethernet port, a HDMI port, 2 USB Type-A 2.0 port, and there's a 3.5mm headphone jack also. There's one USB Type-C 3.0 port and then a micro SD port where you can put in your SD card. And on the right side, there's an optical DVD drive. Well, in some models, you don't get that. Well, who needs that in 2018? And on the front bottom, there are two stereo speakers of 1.5 watt each. So now let's talk about what's under the hood. So you'll be getting the Intel i3 6th generation CPU in this laptop, and the model number for the same is 6006U, and it's built on top of the 14 nanometer process technology, and it has two physical cores and four logical threads for each of the core. Well, the CPU doesn't support the Intel Turbo Boost technology, and the base frequency for the CPU is only 2.0 GHz and no burst clock speed because of that. And at the same time, this CPU has Intel HD520 integrated graphics support, which is quite useful for handling day-to-day graphic usage. And this CPU was launched back in 2016, so quite old, but I guarantee this will never disappoint you in your day-to-day usage, because I'm personally using a i3 based laptop. 6th generation and 7th generation i3 CPUs are quite similar, only the clock speeds are little higher in the 7th generation. So long story short, if you are going to buy a laptop with i3 processor, consider buying a laptop with either i3 6th gen or i3 8th gen. Don't go for 7th gen. So that's a suggestion from my side. So talking about the memory part of this laptop, so it has the 4GB DDR4 RAM and has a memory clock speed of 2133 MHz, so that's quite normal, I guess. And I don't know whether this RAM is embedded in the motherboard or it's like inserted separately, so I can't tell you guys whether you can upgrade or expand RAM in future or not. Because generally laptops coming these days get RAMs embedded in the motherboard. You can see here, right after boot up, it has 2GB RAM ideal. So what I suggest is 4GB is enough for Windows 10. Like you can do day-to-day tasks easily. There's a 1TB hard disk drive for your storage requirements and no SSD, sorry, and no M.2 slot, sorry. The keyboard on this laptop is quite good, I would say, considering its price point. So that's a thumbs up. And I forgot to mention you about the price of this laptop. Actually, I bought this laptop during the recent Amazon Great Indian Festival sale, and I got it like for only 20,000 rupees. So currently it's retailing around 22,000 to 24,000, and for that price it is also good, so you can get that. Buying links are below in the description, so do check that out for more details. So now talking about the touchpad, so touchpad on this laptop is quite good, again considering the price. It's like any other laptop, nothing special. And one thing I need to say you guys, that it doesn't support the multi-finger gestures natively. But you can get that by installing touchpad drivers from the Lenovo website. So this laptop comes in two variants. The one with me is of 14 inches and the other one is of 15.6 inches. And the price difference between both of these variant is 1000, I guess. So you can choose which one to go for. Talking about the battery backup of this laptop, so nothing special here again. You will get 3 to 4 hours of decent backup, like any other laptops, for moderate usage. And you will get 2 to 3 hours of battery backup in case of heavy usage. So this is pretty much everything about the Lenovo IdeaPad 320. Hope you guys like this video. If you like, then press that like button. And if you didn't, then you can press that dislike button. Let me know in the comments box why you dislike this video, so that next time I can improve that. Till then, have a great day ahead. This is Uttam, you're watching Lazy Techno Tricks. I am signing off for now, and we will meet again in some other video.